starting a prayer service immediately, so as per family's request, there is no viewing at this time. But just after the prayer service, we'll have time for visitation, so please do not come to the casket right now. Please take your seats. The viewing will start immediately after the prayer service. Pastors, this front row is reserved for you. Pastors, clergymen, please occupy the front row. This is reserved for you.
Let's spend a moment in silence. Reverend fathers, pastors, friends, loved ones, and family, today I stand in front of you with a deep hole in my heart. We are here to bid farewell to a man with so many hats and so many titles, an endowed professor, a successful businessman, a motivator, mentor, chef. He was a legend. More than that, Dr. George Peter was a humble man, full of love, strength, and encouragement for all of us. He leaves behind his beloved wife, Rose, his children, Chris, Kevin, and Demetria, his siblings, nieces, nephews, cousins, extended families, colleagues, friends, and his beloved students. George hails from the famous family called Kokul family of Teta, a village near Ernakulam, Kerala. The clergy from Kokul family stood as a strong pillar of Syrian Orthodox Church for over a century. George Peter's great-grandfather, Very Reverend Matthai Kordiskopa Achen, served as a long-time secretary and a close friend of His Holiness Saint Devergis Mar Gregorius of Parimala, popularly known as Parimala Kachubirmin. In the next generation, George's grandfather, known as Tokul Achen, was also an Orthodox priest and a Syriac teacher to many clergies of the Indian Orthodox Church. Dr. George Peter's family has requested for a prayer service in Malayalam then officiated by Reverend Father Philippus Scaria, the resident vicar of St. Thomas Orthodox Church of Hollywood. There will be no visitation during the prayer service. Visitation will start immediately after the service. Thank you for your cooperation. Attack, please.
Thank you. Thank you. ചെല്ലുമുള്ളവരെ ജോർജ് ബീറ്റിന്റെ വേർപാടിൽ ഹോളിവുഡ് സെന്റ് തോമസ് ഇടവകയുടെ ഇതായ എല്ലാ ആദരാഞ്ജലികളും അനുശോചനവും പ്രാർത്ഥനയും പ്രത്യേകമായിട്ട് സമർപ്പിക്കുന്നു. ദൈവം എല്ലാവർക്കും സമാധാനം ശാന്തി തട്ടെ എന്ന് കൃത്യമായിട്ട് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കും. ഇങ്ങനെ ഒരു അവസരം ലഭിക്കുവാനിടയായി ദൈവത്തെ സ്തുതിക്കുകയും ചെയ്യും. എല്ലാവർക്കും നന്ദി കരയട്ടെ. എല്ലാവർക്കും ഇരിക്കാം, സിറ്റ് ഡൗൺ.
On behalf of the needy family of Dr. George Peter, I thank Father Philippos Scurria, the resident vicar of St. Thomas Orthodox Church, Hollywood, for coming over here and offering the prayers. I believe that it was very comforting for the family in India too. We have many clergymen in our midst today. We will start our visitation right now. So the order of visitation is you need to line up and come through the middle, the aisle is open, and go to your left side and you may sit down or exit the door. As you know that the pandemic is still in rise, try to avoid touch and body contact. George always say that namaste is the best way to wish a welcome or say thanks and gratitude. Namaste, like with your hands together and bowing. I think that's the best way for during the COVID time too, and I hope you will all cooperate with that. So we can start the visitation from the back now. And our policy today is an open eulogy. The mic will be here. Anybody can come in, say their eulogies, sing a song, hymn, whatever you want to do, you can do because it's an open mic. But at this time, we have Reverend Shivi Abraham of Marthama Church of South Florida with us today. And we are so thankful for our chairman, Pachaman, as they are here to bid farewell to Dr. George Peter. Before I invite attend for the eulogy and prayers, we also have the senior pastor of Seventh-day Adventist Church, Pastor Joseph Salatin from California. He'll be officiating the funeral services tomorrow. We are so thankful for Pastor Salatin to be in our midst today. We have a whole host of colleagues, students. You have time for visitation and eulogies today, but I invite Achen for the eulogy.
Not by the amount of money they can lay or the enable us to share in the life of the Son. We're all better people for knowing Him and for encountering Him. We're all better people for having the privilege to be part of His life. Jesus Christ told the disciples, "I go and prepare a place for you. You see, in my Father's house there are many mansions, and I go and prepare a place for you." It is our faith and our belief that this dear servant of the Lord, though he's absent in the body, he has gone home to be with his master. Be rewarded for his acts of fellowship, for his acts of kindness. He's a faithful servant who's being blessed by his master. Once again, on behalf of Martin Church of South Florida, our prayers and support of the family and friends. We pray that the peace of God, which passes all understanding, comfort everyone who's here. And know that the memory of the servant will live on in our hearts and our minds. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you, Lord, for your Son, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for the years of service you've rendered your name. Thank you, Lord, for all the people, Lord, he's helped through his ministry. By his teaching, by his leadership, by his example, he has blessed so many people. Father God, we want to thank you, Lord, for his life, for his faith, for his ministry. And we pray, Lord, that you strengthen his family and friends right now. Allow them, Lord, to always realize, Lord, that his memory lives on in their lives. He lives on in their memories, and he lives with you in heaven. And they will see you again one day. This is not the end, Lord, but a transition. May your spirit comfort us all. Today, the day is near. We ask also in Jesus' name. Amen.
Pastor Joseph Salazar, the senior pastor of our Sunday Adventist Church, will be saying some words of comfort for the
as the pastor, I decide to love every human being. And Dr. George Peter is one of those human beings. But there is something special about this great man that I had the privilege to know. And that's the fact that besides just loving him, I admire him. And that's different. It's different because I believe to love somebody is a decision you make. you cannot decide to admire somebody. If you admire a human being, that has to be natural. It has to come natural. I'm here to bring my tribute to this great fellow human being that I very much admire. The Gospel of John, chapter 1, verse 16 says, "And of his fullness we have all received, and grace for grace." A better translation says, "And of his fullness we all received, and grace upon grace." I believe this Bible verse expresses the life of Dr. George Peter, a man that out of God's fullness received grace upon grace. And as somebody that greatly admired him and greatly admires and appreciates his legacy, I can say the same for myself. Out of God's fullness I receive grace upon grace. And some of that grace coming from God has come to my life, to the life and legacy of Dr. George Peter. On behalf of my family, on behalf of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, I want to say thank you. Thank you, God, for such a great man that you've given us grace upon grace through. I would like to express my love and appreciation to Dr. George Peter's family, to his wife, Sister Rose, to his children, Kevin, Christopher, Alicia. May God, in his wonderful love, continue to give us from his fullness and place in your life, even after this very difficult time of loss, may he continue to place in your life grace upon grace. Amen.
While we celebrate the life of in America. Fokar Rafael Reshtov Kailas of Egypt in North America as the president of the organization. I'd like to express condolence and tribute to all brave veterans.
Mic is open for eulogies. Anybody who wants to say a word about eulogy, please come to the mic, introduce yourself, and you can speak. Thank you.
My name is Meda Perez. I was a former student of 11 years.
history, always he's people positively, very motivational. You know, he's a, was a family lover. He always talked about the children, family. And he's one day next.
For me, as I got to know him as an adult, I learned how truly rare it is to know someone friendship relationships across state lines and across oceans, friends and family alike. Eric, you know that everyone in this room can attest to how hardworking and ambitious he was, both in academics, career, personal life, in hobbies, all while still building a beautiful family with Rose Ruki and his three beautiful children. Being a new nurse myself, I had truly looked at him as a role model. He was in New York this past October for an Indian Nurses Association conference, and he stayed with us one night, and I had just made it to my 1 year of being a nurse, and I was telling him all of my concerns about what I should do next. So should I become an MP? Should I go into education? Should I just get experience? And he really had a simple, wonderful way of just making it not seem so overwhelming. It gave me a little bit of insight into his personality as a professor. And after reading a lot of the memories on the memorial page, I got to see that his professor personality ran just as true to his personal life. So much to the point where I wish that I could have been one of his students, because it sounds like he really gave his all. The last time I saw George McGill back in October, I was working the day that he was going to leave, so I said my goodbye the night before, because I try to leave by 6 a.m. in the morning. So I'm making my coffee, it's like 5:50 in the morning, I'm trying to be really quiet, and I hear footsteps behind, and he comes up, and I turn and I look, and he's smiling at me, and just wanted to wish me a good day at work. Goodbye, and I tried not to do the same with my sister while the rest of the house was asleep. And that's the type of man that he was. He was the type of person that when you thought you were all alone, he saw you, he heard you, he cared about you, and he even made you laugh. So to everyone who knew and loved him in this room and watching on the live stream, I hope we can take these lessons that he would teach us ever so gently, because he was such a natural. And pass them on so his memory and his legacy can live on as well. And to Rose, JT, and Chris, and Kevin, and Alicia, I mean, this is the most, I know that I see this in you guys, but the best parts of him are within you always. So on behalf of my parents and my sisters and his family and you, we are offering our most sincere condolences and we're praying for you guys.
Children, relatives, and family friends. Today we are so saddened for the death of Mr. George, Dr. George Peter. I know him personally and the day he came to Florida. He struggled a lot in the beginning, but he was so ambitious. He was so down-to-earth, simple and humble person. Because of his ambition, he changed his mind and turned to major field. He did his R&D, then BSN, MS, then doctorate in nursing. He was teaching as a professor in the nursing college. Because of his ambitious and great thinking person, he was known to all our community. We lost a very great leader in the community. That this loss is not not only for the family members, but also for the entire community. I pray that the Heavenly Father bless and comfort Rose and family. On behalf of Federation of Kerala Association North America for Kerala National Committee, as well as Indian Overseas Congress of USA National Committee, I deliver my heartfelt condolences and prayers to the Deity family. Thank you. facilitator for one of these groups in which he was always there. He posed some of the most interesting questions, challenged us to think, and he was a breath of fresh air. And that I can say freely and nothing about it. His humor was one of the first things that captured us. He was irreverent, and yet it was captivating. And he took every opportunity to lighten an atmosphere. And we enjoyed it. We studied a lot. He and I had some philosophical discussions that I also enjoyed immensely, because he brought to me a different perspective on things that in my own bubble of experience I may not have known otherwise. And so I enjoyed talking to him. I enjoyed sharing with him. I enjoyed even debating with him. And in so doing, he sharpened me, and we enjoyed dialogue. I have to say, it goes without saying, we missed him. I miss him. Our study group misses him. Our church misses him. And it is to us as much a shock that our friend is gone. But we have hope. And we know, and from my discussions with George, that there are things that we have to admit we do not know, meaning that we still have hope, and we still hope that our friend is going to one day be with us. At this moment here, I send again my condolences from our study group and from me. I give you my own sorrow and sharing in what you're going through right now. But thank you, we'll miss you.
And he said, you know, my wife is a nurse, my husband. I said, yeah, really, she's a nurse? Yeah. And that's how our friendship went through, just being as a nurse. He said, yes. He was so humble. He got me to be his best friend. I never knew that. He was a professor then. He said, yes, Nancy, you can come to the college.
As it's been said already this evening, he was such a humble guy, and he really was. I worked with his kids and Pathfinders for over 10 years, and he's been coming to the church, and he's done seminars, but I never knew that George was a doctor until one seminar, and he said something to that effect. He was such a humble guy who enjoyed talking to people, he enjoyed giving out advice, he enjoyed making some random jokes and giving out random facts about things. I mean, those of you who know George, you know that he did that a lot, and he was just a great guy to be around. And I am privileged to have had the opportunity to just spend time with him in so many relaxed atmospheres. We've gone to marriage retreats together, and I got to see him with Rose just in a nice and relaxed way as a husband, and it was good times. And my family and I were just looking at pictures today, and I remember one Christmas party, Rose was sitting on his lap, and he just tried to stay low key, but he was having a good time. And just, that was George. He was low key, he was relaxed, he was humble. I'm going to miss those times we had together, miss the times that we would meet at Dunkin' Donuts in our small group to just talk about life. I've had so many conversations with him about our kids. Our kids are the same age and, you know, going through the same things, and it was just great to know George Peter. Rose and Chris and Kevin and Alicia, to his brothers, on behalf of my family, our condolences. We love you guys, we love George, and may he rest in peace.
I came up to support my brother, but he let me alone. It's fine. Thank you. I met George about 10 years ago. Along with his family, he attended Plantation Seventh-day Adventist Church. Like my friend said, we just have so many good memories about George. Always sharing, always so humble in the way he talks and presents himself. Anytime you talk to him, you will always learn something new. Up to this day, I still practice breathing exercise that he taught me. I don't know if it was making fun of me, but up to this day, I still do it, and it works well. And he is just that type of person. Always trying to make things better. Always trying to share and give of himself to make a difference. I remember going over to his house and spending time with the family and the men's ministry. We just play dominoes and games, and George would just feed us. It was just an amazing time, just spending time with them and being able to share good time with the family. We've been on many trips also, men's convention, Irish retreat, as my brother said. He is just a fun guy to, he's just a fun guy to be around. He was just always trying to make your life a better life. The tips and the lesson he shared every time was so she appeared, it's practically the same because we know how good a person George was. A person who always wanted to make a difference. So as we celebrate the memory of who George was, I'm open praying that we all will take a page out of this book and be the person to always pour into somebody else, always share and always be caring. Make sure that you're trying to be better and help others to be better. Our love and our prayers are with you and your family, friends, the plantation family, Seventh Day Adventist Church, will always be there to support you and pray and help you in whichever way. We love you. We love you. We live this church. Thank you.
George was my dearest friend. We've been friends for 31 years. And pretty much, and we grew up together here in the United States. We met in 1998. And we were certain persons to live together. So we lived in Rose and up there and got married. Families have been friends. Very sophisticated gentleman. I'm going to miss him. We have multiple great memories that we shared. He loved my parents, and I loved his parents, Rose's parents, Rose's mom, and brother and sister. And then with our mother's support, we have one named Kevin and Alicia. George, I don't know what to say. I'm going to miss you.
Rose, Kristen, Kevin, Alicia, all the other members of the family. My name is Wesley Jackson. I met George about 24 years ago. We met in school and we completed our degrees. And then I recruited him to come work where I was working, which has really worked until his death. George was a very fun-loving person. And over the years that we have been friends, I found that to be true. He was caring. In 2014, he and I took me to India for 3 weeks with him. And during those 3 weeks that we were there, we went and we provided medical care for the lepers. And that's when I found out that he was really a caring and a sharing person. Until the last time I spoke with him, he was encouraging me, I was encouraging him with some issues that were going on. And he is that positive person. After we finished our graduate degree, George and I enrolled in the same university to complete our doctorate degrees. And we did. He had surgery one semester and took that semester off. So I graduated one semester before him. And I did not go to my graduation. I waited until he finished. And then we both went to graduation together. That's the kind of relationship that we had. He was very supportive. We were in our studies both times. I mean, he came to my house, I went to his house on numerous occasions. I knew about his children's birthdays and so forth. Same thing, he knew about mine and so forth. But I will miss that relationship that I had with him as a friend, but also as a colleague over these years. And that will be sadly missed. So to the family, from my family to yours, my deepest condolences to you.
Good evening, family and friends. My name is Elias. I'm the secretary of Nova Kerala Malaria Association of South Florida. I know Mr. George Peter for many years. We used to go to the same church for service, St. Thomas Indian Orthodox Church of South Florida. He was the member of that church a long time back. I was one of the guests of his wedding. I know him many years. He was a sincere and honest and very quiet person. He was a loving person. Departure is always painful, no matter at what age that happened. Peter's death is really painful. Not only the family, the community, and also Nova Kerala Malaria Association of South Florida. He was a part and parcel of our association. He was a member. And we remember that he was very helpful for our many programs. especially for we used to have a spelling bee competition, and he was one of the main coordinators, and he was very active, and he was very supportive to the family, to the association, as well as for the community as a whole. His departure is really, really painful for all of us. At this time, on behalf of Nava Kerala Malayali Association of South Florida, I extend our heartfelt condolences to the grieving family and friends. May God comfort you and strengthen your heart. May God bless you.
Please join with me to sing this hymn of praise. There's a land that is fairer than day, and by faith we can see ever far, for the Father waits over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
I'll sing that song and chorus in Malayalam. George Peters, mother tongue.
Shobhayeru monadundadu kaname dure vishwasata tadivasam
we shall meet.
families and friends. Please come.
Today's visitation will be done by 9 o'clock. So you have a couple of minutes to come and view the casket. And the last few minutes will be for the family. So if anyone is there to pay the last respect, please come and pay the last respect. George's family wants to sing a song of praise in Malayalam. So I thought of singing a song in Malayalam, or if you just want to come in and pay the last respect and pain.
Rahu Mandakaram Vigil Shri.
Tomorrow morning, the visitation is going to start at 10 o'clock and the funeral service is going to start exactly at 11 in the morning. So, on behalf of the family, we are sending our invitation to be a part of Dr. George Peter's celebration of life tomorrow morning, starting at 10 a.m. Thank you.
So, I didn't know Dr. Peter that well, but I did see who he was through his kids. And I see it today too, and you, Miss Rose, you guys both raised such amazing kids. Chris, Kevin, Alicia. And I think back to the times when we would have little get-togethers at your guys' house, and he was always so hospitable, and he would always be encouraging us all to eat as much as you guys want, and he was always laughing and joking with us, and I just know that through each and every one of you guys, Chris, Alicia, Kevin, you guys are going to show people who your father was, and you guys are all showing who he is today and every single day, and I love each and every one of you guys so much, and I'm praying for you guys every single day, and I just love you guys. I love all of you guys.
I know this will be his last few minutes, so for family, so I'm going to say a few words to the family. Rose, Chris, Kevin, Alicia, my most sincere condolence to all of you. I must say that I met
during good and bad time, you deserve praises. We're asking you, Lord, to please be with all of us in this terrible time. We count on you, we depend on you. Please, may your peace rest upon us. This peace that you only one can give, the one that surpasses all understanding. In Jesus' name.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, on behalf of the family, a sincere thank you tonight for your love. Everything that you have done for this family means so, so very much to them. We'd like to invite you tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. to come. Visitation will begin. Our funeral service will begin at 11 a.m. Once again, on behalf of this family, a sincere thank you. We ask that you please go in peace. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.